Hi, welcome to Math 100 Math for Liberal Arts. I'm Haonian Vu, your professor, and let me tell you about this course. The main idea of this class is to lay out the mathematical foundations for things you see around you in life. These include finance, data and statistics, music and arts and politics, how to use a spreadsheet program such as Excel or Google Sheets, and critical thinking, among other things. I may change the specific topics from one semester to the next, emphasizing some and de-emphasizing others, but the one part that will always be here is finance. Finance will always be a part of this class because, to paraphrase the comedian John Lovitz, if you don't know about money, people will just take advantage of you. A question that's probably on everyone's mind is, how much math do you need for this class? You need to be able to understand the formula, plug the numbers in, and carry out the calculations correctly using the right order of operations. Many of you may know order of operations as PEMDAS. You also need to know how to solve simple equations, mostly linear equations. But the linear equation may be wrapped inside a form that make them look complicated. You should also need to know basic geometry, such as the different shapes and the common formulas for perimeter and area. One section of the class will require logarithms, so I'll teach you the basics of that. You can use a calculator, and I will help you learn to use your calculator correctly. For this class, you will need at least a scientific calculator. The bottom line is, I need you to not panic. Every complicated thing in this class, it's actually simple, and I'll be there to help you along. Now, if you don't have a scientific calculator, you need to go get one. How can you tell that a calculator is scientific? Easiest indication is that it actually says scientific on it. I recommend sticking with the major calculator manufacturers like TI, Casio, Sharp, HP, because when they say scientific, they mean it. For purposes of this class, you definitely need to make sure your calculator has the raised to power key and the logarithm key. The raised to power key looks like one of these, depending on the model. Especially that last one, some of you may not know that it's a power key. It looks like you're raising the power up. And the logarithm key, they look like one of these, with LG and LN. A scientific calculator usually costs around $20, $25. A calculator that's less than $10 is probably not good enough, and one that's $50 or $100 is probably way overkill. One way you can save money is to buy a used calculator online and then sell it back after you're done for pretty much the same price you bought it.
That's all, folks.
That's pretty much it. Welcome to the class.